Hello everyone, welcome to the second part of TouchDesigner for Beginner series. In this video, we are going to explore feedback from texture operator in TouchDesigner. In the last video, we created this render from a sphere. If you want to know how we did it, please watch the first part. So we want to continue working on this render, but you can bring a video to work on that. It's important that your video or your input is moving, because if it's just a still image, it doesn't work very well. So first thing I do here is that I bring a feedback after my composite. After feedback, I add a level. And after that, we add a composite. Connect your first node to composite. Drag and drop the composite on feedback. Now everything turns black, because our operation in our composite is on multiply. I change it to maximum. And now you will see that it gradually turns to white. To avoid that, we go to level, we go to pose, and we reduce the opacity. You can decide which number you want to put. In our composite in operation, I change the operation to over, and now you can see our effect is different. You can reset your feedback here. But I want to put my operation in my composite on difference. With difference, you always have this flickery effect, but I like it, so I keep it this way. We had an edge before our composite. I changed the color of the edge. And here I go to my sphere and I go to detail and I increase the frequency number to have more points and edges. I want to have a more detailed image. Here in our feedback loop, after the level, I will bring a transform. I change the rotation. And now here from top, I bring the constant. I want to use this channel to control my rotation in my transform. I drag and drop the channel on rotation, choose chop reference. And now in constant, when I change the number, you see that my rotation is also changing. Now here I multiply this script to ABS time.second. And now with changing the constant number, I can define the speed of the ABS time.second script. Now I change the scale. In transform operator, go to tile and change the extend type to hold or mirror. Now if you reduce the scale, I put it on 0.8. Now you can see the tile. we change the scale to lower numbers, then our tiles are smaller. Now I change the extent to hold. What hold does is that it keeps the last pixel on the border of our image and kind of stretch that pixel. You can also play with translate. By changing each one of these parameters, you will get a different effect. We can also animate all these parameters. Now here I change the operation of my composite on maximum. And you can see how it's different. You can play around with the parameters from your transform and you will get totally different visualization. In the next video, we will continue working on this visual and I will show you how to make this visual sound reactive and how to animate these parameters. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you want to get notification for the next video.